Hi everyone, in this framer tutorial we're going to learn how to create this nice gallery with a combination of accordion and the ticker component. As you see, our ticker starts to be animated at hover state, and we can toggle accordions on and off easily. So let's get into it. I'm gonna start by creating a frame which has 860 pixels width. Height doesn't matter for now, and its fill is going to be dark gray 3 from my styles, and radius is going to be 16 pixels. Then I'm gonna rename my new frame accordion. Then I'm going to create another frame inside of my accordion frame, which is going to have 80 pixels of width and 100 pixels of height. And I'm going to place my new frame on the very left of the accordion frame. I'm gonna name it icon, and then I'm going to remove its background color. Since this icon frame is going to contain our plus icon, I'm gonna continue by creating the horizontal frame for my plus icon that I'm going to animate afterwards. So I'm gonna select the frame tool, and when the icon frame is selected, since this new frame needs to be inside of the icon frame, I'm gonna create a horizontal frame and change its width to 24 pixels and height to 6 pixels, and its background color is going to be white. Radius is going to be 2 pixels. Actually, let me zoom in a little bit. I'm gonna make sure that it is perfectly centered inside of the icon frame. Then I'm going to name my new frame H for horizontal, as it's going to be horizontal piece of my plus icon. Then I'm going to clone the H frame that I've just created and rotate it 90 degrees clockwise to create the vertical piece of my plus icon. And then I'm going to name this duplicate V for vertical. Then I'm gonna select both V and H frames and make sure that they are both horizontally and vertically centered. Then I'm going to select the accordion frame, and by clicking the plus icon next to the layout on the right panel, I'm gonna make it a stack, and then I'm gonna make its height fit content. Then I'm going to set its distribute property to start and make its gap 0. Now we can create the holder stack for our category title. So I'm gonna press F to select the frame tool, and then I'm going to draw a frame inside of the accordion and make it a stack again by pressing the plus button next to the layout on the right side panel. And by default, its distribute and align properties needs to be set both center or center or middle. And then I'm going to change its width to fill, and I'm gonna make its height 100 pixels to cover the whole accordion height. Then I'm going to remove its fill under the styles. Then I'm going to select the text tool by pressing T, and as text I'm going to type category 1 and change its color to white. I'm gonna leave the font as inter, and font weight is going to be regular, but I'm gonna increase its size to be 32 pixels. And then I'm going to change one's font weight to bold. Then I'm going to rename the stack that contains our text as title, and I'm going to duplicate it to create the stack that's going to contain our ticker. And I'm gonna rename the duplicated stack as ticker wrap, and I'm gonna delete the text it has. And lastly, I'm gonna set its width to 190 pixels. Since we have the required structure for our component, we can turn our accordion stack to a component by just right clicking and selecting create component from the drop down. And I'm gonna leave the name as accordion. Then I'm going to click the insert button at top left and type ticker in the search box, and drag the thicker component to my accordion component screen. Now we can create the frames that we're going to use as our image holders for our thicker, right? So I'm going to press F to select a frame tool, and I'm going to create a frame and make its width 230 and height 136, and change its radius to 16 under the styles. Then I'm going to name the frame image. Now we can fill our image frame with an image we want for our gallery, right? So while the image frame is selected, I'm gonna click the box next to the fill property under the styles, and in the pop-up I'm gonna select the image tab at the very right, and to be able to quickly select an image, I'm gonna click the unsplash button and type design in the search box. And yeah, that's a very proper image, and I'm gonna click this image to fill my image frame with this image. Of course, I can go back and change the focal point by dragging the focus point wherever I want. Then I'm gonna duplicate my image frame, and by double clicking the image it has, I'm going to repeat the process to have four different images for my gallery. I'm just going to click another image to quickly fill my image frame with it, and as I said, I'm gonna repeat the process to have four different images for my gallery. And now that I have images that I want for my gallery, I can connect them to my thicker component by dragging a connection from its right side to each image, just like this. After connecting the images to my thicker component, I'm gonna drag it inside of the thicker wrap frame that I have in my accordion component, and change its width and height to fit my thicker wrap stack by changing both its width and height to fill. Since in the default state of my accordion component, I want my thicker to be static or non-animated, I need to double click my thicker component, and in the component settings, I need to make its speed 0% to make it static. So let's see how our accordion component is doing by command P. And yeah, it looks like it's as we want it to be. Now we can create our accordion's hover state, right? So after selecting only variant of my accordion component, I'm gonna press hover slash pressed button at the bottom, and I'm gonna select hover to create a hover variant. I'm gonna drag it towards bottom a little bit to make some room. Actually, we can make some room. And then, since I want my thicker component to be animated at hover state, after double clicking it at thicker component settings section, I'm gonna make its speed 100%, and then with command P, I'm gonna test to see my thicker component is animated on hover state. And after selecting the primary variant of my accordion component, I'm gonna select icon title and thicker wrap frame and stacks, and then I'm gonna right click to gather them under another stack and name this new stack top part. Now we can create bottom part of our accordion component, right? So I'm gonna select top part stack and duplicate it and rename the new one bottom part, and then I'm going to select the primary variant of my component and make its stack direction vertical. Then I'm going to select all the inner frame and stacks in my bottom part stack and delete them, and then while it is selected, I'm going to add a 1 pixel top border to it. So I'm gonna make other borders 0 to keep the border only on top. It's gonna be a dark gray too from my styles. Then I'm gonna add 30 pixels of top and bottom padding to it. Now we can copy the thicker we have to the bottom part, right? So I'm gonna copy and paste it to the bottom part, and its width needs to be filled, and height is going to be same as the image frame we have, which is 136. Of course, we need thicker at the bottom part to be animated. I'm going to double click it to view the component properties it has, and I'm gonna make its speed 100%, and since we want it to be slower on the hover, I'm gonna make the hover speed 0.5x. Now we can test to see if our thicker at the bottom works. As you see, it works perfectly. Then we can hide the bottom part, as we don't want it to be visible in other variants, right? It needs to be only visible in the open variant. So I'm gonna change its visible property to no, to hide it. Then we can start creating the open variant. And I'm gonna name this new variant open. Then, as we need the bottom part to be visible in the open variant, I'm gonna change its visible property to yes. Then I'm gonna drag an interaction from it to the default variant. And I'm gonna leave the trigger as click. And then, since whenever we click the default variant, we need our accordion to be opened, I'm gonna do the same for the default variant. So let's test it. Yeah, as you see, at hover, our ticker starts to work. And when we click our accordion, our ticker animates nicely to the bottom and becomes a bigger ticker gallery. Honestly, I'm not 100% sure why Framer, like Smart Animate and Figma, animates this ticker to get bigger and to be carried to the bottom part, but it was honestly a happy accident, and I decided to keep it this way instead of keeping a static ticker here next to the category title while accordion is opened. So it looks much better this way. Now we can make our plus icon a component to make it easily animated in all categories or other accordion variants that we're gonna create, right? So I'm gonna select the icon frame, and then by right clicking I'm gonna select create component from the menu and leave the component title as icon. Then in the icon component screen, I'm gonna name the first variant plus, and then create another variant for our minus state of our component. And then I'm going to select V frame in the minus variant, and I'm gonna rotate it 90 degrees clockwise to turn it into a minus symbol. And then to make the animation more interesting, I'm gonna select the horizontal frame and rotate it 360 degrees clockwise, as I said, to make the animation a little more interesting. Then going back to accordion component screen and changing the plus components variant in the open state to minus variant, I'm gonna test to see if our plus animation is working. As you see, it works perfectly. Now that we have our category 1 accordion completed, we can duplicate our primary variant and create a second category. So after duplicating the primary variant of my accordion, I'm gonna delete its interaction and name it category 2. So to continue making the required changes in our category 2 accordion, I'm gonna make the title change. And since we cannot edit our ticker while it's in our component, I'm gonna drag it outside. And in order to be able to assign new images to our ticker component, I'm gonna click the box next to its children property, and by right clicking to an empty space on the right, I'm gonna select remove all from the drop down. Then I'm going to copy an image frame from the previous ticker to keep the form factor consistent. Actually, let me just paste it somewhere near to our new ticker, right? And then I'm going to double click to it to be able to change the image easily. Then I'm going to click unsplash button and type tag this time in the search box to select some different images for my new category. After repeating the process and having 4 new image frames, I'm gonna connect new images to the new ticker elements I have. Then I can drag my ticker component to my new accordion, right? Then we can continue making the changes we need with the bottom part of our new accordion, right? So after selecting the bottom part on the left hand side, I'm going to go to the styles section at the right panel and make it visible. Delete the existing ticker and copy my new ticker element and paste it to the bottom part and change its width to fill and height to, again, same as the image frame height, 136. And then in the ticker component properties section, I'm gonna make its speed 100%, as when bottom part is visible, I need my ticker component to be animated. And again, I'm gonna make its hover speed 0.5x. Now we can hide our bottom part again in the default state of our category 2 accordion, and then we can create the hover state for our new variant, right? And then only change that I need in hover state is making our ticker at the close state animated by changing its speed to 100%. Now we can create the open state of our category 2. So after duplicating the default state of our category 2, I'm gonna name my variant category 2 open, and change the icon components variant to minus. Then all we need to do is making the bottom part in our open state visible and defining the required interactions, right? From open variant to the category 2 and from category 2 to its open state. Now we can test it. Yeah, we can see our category 2 also works. We can go ahead and create a third category, but since there aren't going to be any different actions to keep the tutorial shorter, I'm not gonna do that. As I see it, we need to fix one more thing. Since we have this second ticker also in our category 1 state, I'm gonna delete it. Now we can go back to home screen and create a simulation for 3 different galleries, right? Since the process is going to be the same for creating more galleries or categories. So I'm gonna duplicate the category 1 variant twice and change the middle one's variant to category 2, and with command P, as you see, at hover, each ticker at close state starts to be animated, and we can open and close them individually. Hope you liked the tutorial. Be sure to subscribe and check my other videos if you haven't already, and see you in the next one.